Hello friends, in this video we will discuss coefficient of friction and different types of friction forces. Please make sure you watch different types of forces part 1 to part 4, then go ahead with part 5. So what is coefficient of friction? Coefficient of friction is a measure of the amount of resistance that a surface exerts on substances moving over it. If a surface applies greater resistance, then it will be hard for an object to move on that surface. So, coefficient of friction would be greater for that kind of surface. It depends on nature of both surfaces. Both surfaces means bottom surface of this object and upper surface of this concrete floor. So, if the surface is rough, coefficient of friction would be greater. So, rough surfaces have greater coefficient of friction, while smooth surfaces have less coefficient of friction. And the second is, it depends on surface area in contact. If greater surface area in contact, then amount of friction force would be greater. The formula for coefficient of friction is the ratio between maximum friction force and the normal force. We can write it as mu is the symbol of coefficient of friction equals friction force divided by normal force, FF over FN. Coefficient of friction for a particular surface has a constant number. For example, suppose this is the wooden box, so bottom surface of wooden box is made of wood. Suppose this floor is also made with wood. So both surfaces are wood, means wooden box on wooden floor. In that case, value of coefficient friction would be 0.6. It's a constant number and it would not change. The same way, if the floor is made with concrete, wooden box on the concrete floor, so the coefficient of friction for wood on the concrete would be 0.8. As you know, concrete surface is rougher than the wood surface. That's why the coefficient of static friction is greater for the concrete surface. I have listed different types of friction force here. First is static friction, kinetic friction, sliding friction, and rolling friction. We will learn definition and formula of each type of friction force listed here. So what is static friction force? Its definition is, static friction force is the friction force that exists between a stationary object and the surface in contact. Suppose this box is made with wood, so it is a wooden box, and this floor is made with concrete. Right now this box is at rest on this concrete floor. So initially box is stationary. So basically there are two forces acting on this box. First is force of gravity or the weight of the box which is acting downward. And second is normal force which is applied by the floor on this box acting upward. And these two forces balancing each other, Fn equals Fg at this time. We have already learned about these two forces in previous videos, so please do watch those videos to go in detail. There is no friction force acting on this box right now. Let me show how static friction force works. Now a person starts pushing this box with a force in this direction. At this time, this concrete surface will apply a static friction force on this box in the opposite direction of pushing force, Fs. F stands for force and S stands for static friction. So Fs is for static friction force. We can calculate maximum stationary friction force using the formula Fs equal to mu s times Fn. Mu s is the coefficient of static friction. Fn equals normal force. You know On the plane surface, Fn equals m times g, or you can see weight of the box. So the formula would turn out like this, mu s times m times g. As here concrete surface is flat, so this formula is applicable for flat surfaces. You know, the coefficient of friction for wood on concrete is 0.8, and suppose mass of the box is 5 kg, so m equals 5, and gravity is 9.8, so this will give us 39.2 newtons. So this concrete surface can apply maximum static friction of 39.2 newton on this wooden box. Suppose initially this person pushes this box with 20 newtons only. So this surface would apply a static friction of 20 newtons, means equal to the pushing force in the opposite direction. And so static friction would equal to the applied force by person, which is 20 newton here. Again, this person increases the pushing force to the 30 newtons. So surface also would increase static friction to the 30 newtons. Now person again increases the pushing force to the 39.2 newtons, exactly equal to the maximum stationary friction. So at this point, this boy is pushing the ball with 39.2 newtons. This concrete surface can apply maximum 39.2 newton. So it would apply 39.2 newtons to resist the box motion in the opposite direction. Here you can see both forces are balancing each other. So net force on the box is zero at this point, and box will not move. So box will not move until the person applies a force of 39.2 newton. Next, person will increase the force again to the 40 newtons. So it's applying right now 40 newtons. But this concrete surface can apply maximum stationary friction up to the 39.2 newtons. It cannot apply more than 39.2 newtons. So right now, concrete surface will apply only 39.2 newton in the opposite direction. At this point, net force on this box would be 40 minus 39.2 newtons, that would be 0.8 newtons. So as there is net force on this wooden box, so box will start moving. Once this wooden box will start moving, kinetic friction takes over and static friction stops working. We will learn about kinetic friction force in the next video. So stay tuned and study more. Don't forget to subscribe, share and like for daily updates. Thank you.